Your TeamSpeak push talk key is your direct chat button. That's just how you talk to everybody around you without, talking on the radio or any shit like that. Caps lock is your radio. All right. First important thing. Not sure how many of you don't know this. Control Shift X will bring up your Anchor radio. And then right now you should just have a 343, right?
This is the part where you actually say something.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. 1482, but yeah.
All right.
That's.
Yep.
All right. Cool. Okay. If you press Control Shift and X at the same time, should get the 343 coming up. Should say Acre on the front. TF left side is the channel, and the right side is the volume. To go up or down on either one of those knobs up there. Right click to go down. Left click to go up. But I just have you guys change to channel 2 and then
Yeah.
I don't know, key your radio or some shit.
Yeah, we'll go ahead change the channel too, and then we'll go name by name and you'll sound off.
Armor free.
And then phase on.
Hello.
All right, cool.
Oh, don't let the
Looks like
people with Acre
everybody's
problems
so have
cool,
about
pretty
three
much,
people
yeah.
issue, otherwise yeah, we're good.
All right. All right, so we're just gonna go back to the clusterfuck. I want you guys to grab a 148 now.
So,
And what are you
what's the
grabbing?
default key for direct chat? Not talking over your radio, just talking like
That would be
your
TeamSpeak
TeamSpeak
push to talk
push-to-talk
button.
key.
There is
Okay,
no
cool,
default.
got it. All right, so I have to set that. All right.
Well, it's what you're doing right now.
Yeah, if you're using that key
Yeah,
right
but
now,
I did the lower headset trick. Yeah, to do.
Yeah.
What?
Wait, what?
What do you mean?
You can choose to lower your headset, then when you talk, it won't go over the radio.
Well, it will
It's in the
still go
scroll
over the
wheel
radio.
for me at least.
It goes over the radio, but it just lower. And if you just
It lowers the volume.
you can do it again by doing raise headset.
Oh, okay. Got
Yeah.
It's not a permanent thing.
Your TeamSpeak push-to-talk key will not talk over the radio.
Yeah.
That's what I'm using right now. It's just mouse scroll
Okay,
command.
got it. Yeah, I'll set that when I
Yeah.
can.
Well, I guess it doesn't work with the mic then, but it does work with the output. Your output will be a lot lower.
Yeah, something like that. I don't know.
So if you're
Doesn't
running
really
around
matter. Gotcha.
on the hills or something with your squad and you're sick of hearing everyone else bitch at you can turn off the radio for a second.
All right. So, same as the 343 for this one. Just Control Shift X to open it up.
They'll probably have to control shift A over to it first to select the radio.
Shit, you're right.
Yeah.
Forgot that.
Yeah,
All
sorry
right,
about
yeah.
that. Yeah, go ahead and use the Control Shift A to switch your radio. You'll see the little prompt on the bottom, switch to PRC 148. Once you do, just go ahead and use Control Shift X to bring up your 148.
All right, everybody have it up.
Say something.
So, first thing, how to change channels. It's just on the 148, it's just the up or down arrows. So, up to change channel up, down to change channel down. Not
There's
difficult.
also a knob at the top left you can press there, that one too.
Yeah.
Oh.
I'm not sure how to change the volume without using that knob at the very top center, but that one, the knob up there works fine for volume, so you shouldn't have any issues.
Left click and right click the knob.
Yeah. Same as the 343. Alright, now I think this is the one that kind of messes with some people. We're gonna figure out how to change the power. So, first thing you're gonna want to do is hit mode, and then hit mode one more time. You'll see a thing pop up, cur and new. The cur is current power, new would be the new setting. If you press down on the, or just press the down arrow, then it will, or new will change to 5000. That will increase your power setting after you press E and T. And that is the maximum power setting. It should be good for pretty much all of Stratus.
Not all Stratus. It tends to get
Well,
blocked by hills, but it
yeah.
is a hell of a lot better than 343.
It's 5 kilometers.
Most of Stratus, at least.
I believe.
There are other power settings.
So would there be any reason to keep it on a low power?
Nope, there's no batteries or anything, so...
Usually in TVT situations, but on this shirt, yeah.
Yeah, for a TVT situation, you might want to keep the power lower just for the fact that you don't want them to be able to hear you or what you're saying.
Right.
They might
hear.
Yeah, these are unencrypted, so if you're close enough, your enemy can hear you if they're on the same channel.
Yeah, well, if they're on the same channel, but the 148 has 100 channels, so.
Yeah, I mean, you've got a wide selection to choose from.
I think
contact rifleman.
A more obvious reason for the whole thing is that if you're like in a very large operations with a lot of squads. You can lower the power to make sure you don't bother squad leaders that are far away from you.
That too, yeah.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Two, Team Red.
Also, I've noticed there was
three,
some
Team Green.
About
four, Team Blue.
The symbols.
Five,
so
Team Yellow.
The slash is the squad leader. Sometimes a fire team leader. I'm not sure how that works exactly, but I'm pretty sure it's just the leader of your team.
Yeah, the commander.
The double chevron, so two up arrows on top of each other, is believe that is AT. The up arrow is a automatic rifleman, and then the other one is it's like a greater than or less than symbols with like a line in between them, and that one is I think it's repair specialist.
Potentially stupid question, but really, what does an AT rifleman do? That anti tank.
Yeah, yeah. Anti-tank, yeah.
Okay, so at the moment in the mod, they don't have, like, too much of a purpose, right? You know, because we don't have tank.
Well, I mean,
anti-vehicle as well, so
it's just
you can if
anti-tank, you know.
HMG.
Oh, right.
It's
okay,
just people that have rocket launchers and missile launchers.
Okay, yep, got it.
You'll notice that if you actually pick up an NLAW or something like that, your icon will actually change.
Something else I'd like to add on the Shaktag HUD. Your compass is actually tied to the HUD, so if you were to drop your compass, you lose your bearing on the HUD.
That's a good point.
Nobody really knows that.
I think the second point is if you're not in a squad, your Shaktag HUD won't show up.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you have to be with at least one other person, or you don't get your HUD.
And fireteam colors will also show up on the HUD.
Before we go on, I just want to say one thing about Acre you kind of missed. You have the ability to set a radio to an ear. In order to set a radio to an ear, you have to hit Control Shift and then either the left or right arrow.
And that's useful for, like, I usually set my 343 to my left ear, my squad radio to my right ear.
The talk and direct channel button is the button you have to bind to pop up the Acre adjust.
Okay,
what you do is you hold the button and then you scroll up or down to adjust your volume. It doesn't actually change the volume per se as much as the range at which you can be heard.
So who hasn't set their Acre adjust key?
If you haven't set it up, you need to bind a key to talk in direct channel, which is one of the last under multiplayer options. I suggest numpad 5. You cannot bind it to a mouse key. Make sure you don't try that.
Right now I'm using a tab that works as well.
I use insert.
Yeah, I was thinking about
but if you use tab, then make sure you go into something before you actually alt tab or anything like that, because then you open mic.
Yeah, I got tab set up for this for gestures, so
yeah.
I find that left windows works fine for it.
But how do you know how loud it is?
See a bar while you hold down the button.
Yeah, does it show a bar with like a little
bar with like a little arm?
And it's it says whisper
normal shout.
There've been some issues, but if you can get Acre to work, that should be fine.
Even if I hold it down without scrolling, that
down without scrolling,
not sure if that's supposed to happen.
Yeah, I know that happens.
You might see the arrow move a little bit under it. It's kind of not very visible.
It's sometimes
helpful
to
point up toward the sky.
Just so everyone knows, you don't actually talk with the.
You hear me?
Direct bond key. You can talk you with me? Your normal TeamSpeak key.
Perfect.
Yeah.
Wait, sorry, what was that again? A little confused by that.
You're going to use your TeamSpeak push to talk key to talk, and you're going to use the talk and direct channel key only to change your volume. You should not hold it while talking.
Oh, so how would I talk to people close to me without using my radio?
That would be your TeamSpeak push
your
to talk
push
key.
Your push TeamSpeak up, yeah. TeamSpeak key is, your direct chat button.
Oh, right, right. Okay, yeah. Got it.
Yeah.
I have to set that as well. Okay. Okay, wait. I'm sorry. I'm still confused. So I've got my push-to-talk key set as caps in Acre. I mean, in TeamSpeak. And this uses the radio, correct? Not, doesn't talk to people
around
me.
You have your push-to-talk... No, that's
your push-to-talk
no.
key should no. be a separate key from caps lock.
Put your push-to-talk key on your mouse. Put your caps lock, or caps lock will talk on the radio. Push-to-talk will talk to people around you. You will not talk on the radio if you're using your push-to-talk key.
Okay, so I can change that in TeamSpeak, and when I still press caps, it will work, even though it's not set to caps in TeamSpeak?
Yes.
Yeah.
Because
okay, that's what I was confused about, because I thought it had to be set. Okay, got
the
it.
In-game radio key is set with a config file, which is under user configs.
Okay, yeah, that makes more sense now. I thought it had to be set in TeamSpeak, so I got it.
Yeah, we don't really have a vehicle to sit on. Right now, let's just go to basic. Right now, every helicopter has a vehicle radio, which is a 117 radio. 117s can only communicate with other 117s, with 119s.
No, they can communicate with 119s, 148s.
Yeah, I was
remember, 343s are the only ones that can't communicate with the other radios.
Yeah. And you open
everything
them up
else
by pressing alt, holding alt shift and pressing Q, and then you get a little pop up. You click it, then you click it again, and then you click one more time, I believe. And then you just get an extra radio. You can actually still use your radio while going outside of the helicopter as long as you stay close to it.
Alright, so the standard squad is a squad leader and two fire teams, possibly a medic with that. Standard fire team is the fire team leader, auto rifleman, grenadier, and rifleman. Rifleman can be replaced with a more specialized role, like you can make him a medic or an AT or assistant rifleman. And, I mean, that's not always what happens, but it does happen sometimes. Sometimes they also replace a grenadier. Squad leader leads the squad, listens for order from platoon command. He's the one that will actually make a plan to move somewhere and sort of execute a, like an assault plan or something like that. He's a bit more hands-on than what you would expect from a platoon commander who just says, go here, do this. Fire team leader will lead the fire team, takes orders from the squad leader, and he will be leading the team during an engagement or when you are just like walking around when you need to get into a formation. They'll tell you what formation to be in or
what?
So just things like that. Okay, automatic rifleman. His role is basically to put as many rounds toward an enemy as possible. When you are an automatic rifleman, you should be firing in 3 to 5 round bursts, because you've got a large magazine, you're not going to have any issues with ammo. And you should be walking your fire from side to side. Other than that, as the AR, you should be... you shouldn't really be thinking as much about hitting things as suppressing them, especially when we're playing TVTs. Not so much when we're playing against AI, because AI just doesn't, suppression doesn't work. You fire a couple of rounds at them, and then they destroy you with their lasers.
Great.
Yeah, it's kind of useless.
Actually,
for now.
Suppression, they have plans to add suppression to AI, but, and it's, I think it's even there already, but it's not implemented properly.
Yeah, it doesn't really work.
It's a suppression script, but I don't know if we...
Alright, Grenadier, what he does, he's gonna launch high explosive grenades at the enemies. Depending on the situation, you know, he might launch 4 or 5, he might launch everything he has, he might only launch one. That's sort of just up to you as a grenadier, that's just, you know... It's at your discretion. If there's one guy, obviously you shouldn't be wasting every grenade you've got. If you've got a platoon of guys and they're all hiding places and you want to just launch as much as you can down there, anything in between that, just pick a number between that. Sort of after you've run out of grenades, you're basically functioning as a rifleman. And a rifleman is basically the team bitch. He does whatever is necessary. You know, he will carry extra ammo or things like that, and that'll be especially important, like when we get into Ace. That hasn't really been an issue yet. You know, anybody can carry pretty much as much weight as they want, but once you have to actually mess with weight, the rifleman will start holding more of the, like, extra ammo for the automatic rifleman. If there's no assistant AR or anything like that, it'll carry extra HE grenades, things like that.
Oh, not yet, but we will as soon as Ace actually comes out. I mean, yeah. Goddamn.
Yeah.
You're gonna need it. I mean, there have already been situations where we have run out of ammo, so...
Yeah, trigger discipline will be a little easier too with Ace, for the fact that you can put your weapon on safe.
Yeah.
Alright, next thing is we're gonna go over formations, order of march, and arcs of fire. First thing, order of march. It's literally just the order of people in a formation. It's dependent on the mission and the fire team or the squad leader. And as far as you know, A3G goes, we don't really do much of that. There's not anything that we really bother with there. It's just sort of an every man for himself. But sometimes it is helpful to have certain people in certain places, especially in you know, specific formations, so that you can cover areas with, you know, equal amounts of fire, things like that. Formations. I guess we could get instructors to do the formations really fast. Alright. First one I want to talk about is the column or the file. So you guys, yeah, get into a column. There we go. We can get the outline here so I can't see you guys. Basically, what a column is... You can, it's a, well, it's a column or a file. It doesn't really matter what you call it, just one of those two. It is a, it's a, just a line from back to front. You follow somebody, you know, just in a straight line. Not a big deal. You do it all the time in stores and whatever. It's used, for fast movement, and for fire team leaders, it's, good to keep command of your team. Keep control of everybody, know where everybody's at, you know. It's, good for walking around in a safe area, but if you were going to, if you expect any contact at all, then it is really the least optimal formation. Sorry, what?
It's also good for minefields.
Yeah, it's good for minefields. If you get somebody to walk up front with a mine detector and then have everybody follow in a really close column.
Grid 0, 2,
that,
0,
definitely
0, 5,
helps things.
6. I'm ready.
One thing I would say
blue.
About this is you do, or this and formations in general, when you are making one, you should watch your spacing. So, yeah, you guys should probably spread out a little bit. There you go. I know you guys can't see on your Shack Tech HUD.
4, return to formation.
But, yeah, right about like that. That's good enough. The reason you watch your spacing, it's, you know, it's not meant to be anything, it's not meant for you, you know, to look pretty or anything like that. If I throw a grenade right now, and I throw it here, I'm gonna hit Sonics, but I'm not gonna get Spin or Meh. And that's, you know, the purpose of spacing. It's not so that everything looks nice. I just don't want everybody to be huddled up into a tiny little group and then get taken out by one grenade.
Next.
Alright, next one. Staggered column.
4. Form on me!
And... Here, Sonics, you go left. Spin, you go right. And then... Echelon, you go left. Yeah. Alright, this isn't one that we've used too much, if you can't tell. It's literally, it's just a zigzag back and forth. And really the purpose of it is for, if you're walking along roads that might have mines on them or something like that, if you are, walking in a tight city street with walls or something like that, just anywhere where maybe one side of a column wouldn't be able to see over a wall or something like that. So, say there's a wall on just either side of them, to their left and to their right. Sven and Meh, on the right side, would be watching the left side to make sure that there is, you know, nothing peeking over that wall or getting ready to shoot or whatever over that wall.
Return to formation!
And then Sonics and Echelon would be over the right side of that wall. And just covering pretty much everywhere, up in the windows in a building, up on the roofs. Yeah, sorry. It's not something I can make, unfortunately. But yeah, that's pretty much all about the staggered column. Next is the line. Alright, yeah. Line is probably the most important formation. The big thing about a line is, you know, it's not really... It's pretty close to a column.
Four!
It's,
form on me!
You know, not good for moving most of the time. But it is... it's effective for putting down as many rounds toward an enemy as possible. So, you know, you've got an enemy to the... west. If you make a line that faces west, everybody's got their weapons pointed in that direction. Everybody is able to put, you know, rounds at that enemy. And you've got okay coverage of your flanks from the guys on the outside of that line. And then the only other time that I would use a line if you're not engaging an enemy is if you are coming out of like a... wooded area, something like that, where there's trees covering your sides and you know you can't really be caught unaware from your sides. That will give you, you know, good coverage there.
Four. Right, the, return next to one, formation.
Or the next formation is the echelon. And this one is literally, it's just a diagonal line. It's pretty much a yeah, just go echelon left on meh. Diagonal line to either the right or left off the person who is in the front. The big thing about this is it's just a compromise between
grid zero,
the
two,
line
zero,
and the
zero, five, six, waiting.
Column. But yeah. Echelons are literally just diagonal lines, not that big of a deal. We don't use them too much. Basically, the reason you would use them is if you want to cover a specific side. So echelon left would cover your left side, echelon right would cover your right side. It doesn't give you great security to your to the opposing side, so whichever side you don't choose. So. If you're walking around an AO or something like that, you expect contact from a specific side, you can use an echelon to try and work around that, you know. Yeah, Goose, you can just go over there and get in the line with everyone else.
He's not on TeamSpeak.
Oh.
He is on TeamSpeak, I heard him.
Okay, yeah. Well, whatever. He can do whatever he wants. I don't care as long as he doesn't fuck with everything. I don't give a shit. Alright. Next one is the wedge. Just do a wedge heavy left.
I don't even remember what the wedge is.
It's just a wedge. Like that. Like that. You're good. Just stay where you are.
Okay, I'll stand here.
You're fine.
I pretty much know all of them except wedge.
Yeah.
Wedge is just a reverse feat.
Alright, yeah, so that's the wedge right there. If you, generally, if you're in a four-man team, if they say heavy left, that means two people on the left, one person on the right. If they say heavy right, that's two people on the right, one person on the left. Pretty simple. The wedge is used to maintain 360-degree security. So if you're walking through an area where you're not sure where you're going to take contact or whatever, you can... use the wedge to make sure that everybody is watching, you know, a certain area, make sure that everybody is knows where the hell they're going. Or not where the hell they're going, but where the hell they need to look and, you know. Yeah. So, in this one, guy in the back in the left here would be watching toward the back. I mean, not the whole time, but, you know, he'd be checking the back. And then everyone else in that front would be watching front, left would be watching left, and right would be watching right. Pretty simple, not a big deal, and we haven't really used much of that. I've heard a little bit of though, so.
The blob formation.
Blob formation is at the end.
Blob formation is at the end. We'll get to it. Alright. And then, Sven, if you just want to move over behind that, we'll go to the diamond. And then right there, that is the diamond. It is pretty much a no-compromise formation. You've got somebody looking in every direction. You've got somebody covering every direction, and you are not, you know, sacrificing anything. One of the... This is, you know, again, for 360 degree security. You want to make sure that you're covering every angle. The important thing about this one is when you are moving, you don't need to be looking in that direction. So when you're actually moving, you just look straight front, and then you can check your direction, whatever. Make sure that everything's okay. But yeah, when you're moving, you just look straight front like every other formation. It's ridiculous to have to move backwards or sideways or whatever. It doesn't usually work. So, yeah. Diamond, when you stop, though, you should look outward and make sure that, you know, nothing is anywhere around you, whatever. Wait for your team leader to make a plan or whatever happens. The, really big part about this one, the, most important purpose, I would say, is for, VIP protection. Say you've got, someone you're supposed to be protecting. If you make a diamond around that person, you'll be able to see everywhere, you know, around you. You'll be able to protect him. If, say for instance, you start taking fire, what you can do is you can collapse on that VIP, so you can get around him as close as possible. And then just keep facing outward, keep firing, you know, make sure that you are protecting him, and then you can move in that formation to, keep the... VIP protected. Let's see, what else?
It's also good for protecting medics.
Yeah.
When they're reviving.
Yeah, that's a good point. It's, say you got someone down, if you make a diamond around them and you, protect your medic while he's reviving them, you'll have a better time getting everyone up.
And then you get a visit from the AKP of death.
Yeah. Alright, and then the last one, tactical blob, because I'm not going to go over the V, it's pretty much useless. And that's literally just, you know, a blob. Just stand wherever you feel like. Usually as close together as possible. And
yeah, you have to be in a...
Okay, can we stop firing, please? What? But I mean, yeah, you just run around, do whatever you want. Pretty much, yeah, medics in front, squad leaders in front, just everybody who you don't want to get shot, you put them all the way up in front. You get a VIP, you put him in front, and you make him walk at least 15 meters ahead.
Make the,
He looks for mines, that's his job.
Yeah, he looks for mines, but you don't give him a detector, you just, he
just has to look with his eyes.
If you put he works with his eyes or his feet.
Or his feet.
Yeah, and pretty much the best part about this formation is if you want to die, you know, if you want to take a grenade and you want it to kill as many people as possible, that's the best part about this. If I threw a grenade down there right now, I could kill 5 people. It'd be great.
This is the official formation of A3G, by the way. So
yeah.
This will be on the test, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, you will need to take this incredibly seriously.
Exactly, we do take this very seriously. We ban people for not following the tactical blob.
It's pretty strict.
Do you understand me, ladies and gentlemen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Alright, So, pretty much, pretty much the last thing I have to talk about with formations before we actually try any of these. Just arcs of fire.
What now, fear?
Where you should be looking while you're in a formation.
Where is he?
This is where you should be looking in a formation. You know, pretty much as a general rule, if you are looking, or if you're in the front of a formation, you should be looking front. If you're in the back, you should be looking toward the back. Not looking the whole time, just like checking the back. Make sure there's nothing behind you. And make sure there's nothing behind you, because I've seen times where there have been just people, you know, following someone and they don't check back and then they get shot. And then the only real exceptions here are the column and the staggered column. And the column, just as a general rule, just look left, right, left, right, if you're not in the front or back. And the staggered column, I already told you about this, just look to the right if you're on the left side, left if you're on the right side. No big deal there. Fuck. Actions on contact. Basically, it's just what you do when you see someone, when you're being fired upon, when you hear something, you know, whatever. First thing to know, if they don't hear or see you, don't fire back until whoever's leading you tells you to fire. You don't want to start a firefight when nobody's ready, because, I mean, that'll get everyone killed. If they have fired back, or if they've fired upon you, the first thing you should do is turn to them, fire a couple of times, call contact, and then find some cover about 5 to 10 meters away. You don't want to go too much further than that, otherwise you'll have to, you know, you'll be running too far. It'll be a good target. If you can't find cover, then just drop to the ground, go prone. Alright, and then, calling on contact. It's pretty simple. It's just, the word contact, then the direction. And, you know, some people feel one way, some people feel another way. It doesn't really matter. The way that I think you should do it is just call out a general cardinal direction. So north, south, east, west, northwest, southwest, east, or southeast. You know, any of those 8 will be more than enough to go for, because, you know, most of the time you don't really want to pull out your
contact here, man,
trying to shoot something.
Sven, engine off.
If they still can't find it after that, wait until after you've called the rest of it, and then you can start giving a description. Another thing that people have been talking about that would be helpful is if you give them like an elevation. You know, you don't have to tell them it's 300 meters off sea.
Contact rifleman.
Like, just, you know, tell them, you know, middle of the hill, top of the hill, bottom of the hill, something like that, just so that they can get a relative area. After you've called out the direction, you call out the distance, so, you know, the easiest way to do distance is if it's within 200 meters, call close. If it's 200 to 600, call medium. If it's further than 600, far. That's pretty much the easiest way to do that. And, you know, just judging distance is a bit difficult, but, you know, you'll start to get it more as you call it out. The next thing you want to call out is just the size. You know, how many are there? Is there one guy? Are there 20? You know, are you facing a whole platoon or just a fire team or just one random guy wandering around by himself or patrol or whatever? And you can call that as a squad. You can say 8 people. You can say whatever, you know. And then after you've called out the size, the amount of things that are there, call out what it is, the unit or whatever, you know, just like, is it a tank, is it a helicopter, just, you know, foot soldiers, hunter, ifrit, whatever, armed or not. And then that should be enough for that. If you see them and they're not firing, you can just call out a visual contact so that, you know, you don't have people turning toward it and thinking they're being fired upon or whatever. If you hear it, say, like an infrared or something.
Firing.
We are being fired upon.
I don't even care.
Contact
unless someone dies.
That's currently.
Yeah, exactly like that.
Curly.
Of course it's curly. So like this. Say that helicopter is over the hill, you can't see him.
Yeah, wow. I can't see him anymore.
Yeah, yep, like that.
Good job.
But good job, guys.
We took him out.
Nice.
Hell yeah.
Contact down.
And we were in a tactical blob. Good job, guys. So
yeah.
Indeed.
Perfect. Every HAG situation.
That's how we do it every time for
attack. Don't move. Don't shoot. Stay in a tactical blob.
Exactly.
And wait for it to kill itself.
Keep continuing. You have to continue.
And make sure to fire in the air to get its attention. Remember to
always continue your conversation. What you were saying is more important.
Alright, sorry about that, Valder. Go on.
Yeah, no, it's cool. Alright, I went over visual contact. If you hear them, but you don't see them, you can call it audio contact. So there's an IFRIT or something, you know, like a kilometer away, and you can't see it, but you can hear it. Call it audio contact. One of the biggest things that I found, especially in TVTs, but, you know, just, in general, if you
contact
are firing
soldier.
At an enemy, unless nobody can see them anymore, or you, and I'm talking like over a hill, they've escaped, kind of, can't see them, not just behind a tree, you can't see them.
Four, return to formation!
Yeah. Unless you just can't see them, unless they've, you know, they're just not in that area anymore,
halt.
Don't stop firing. Especially with people, if they're behind cover and you stop firing, that'll give them a chance to get out of cover and start firing back at you. But if you don't, it'll suppress them. It'll keep them, you know, down behind that cover, hopefully.
Can we get a medpack to get this guy stop moaning?
Okay, yeah. And then the last thing I have to say about, you know, contact and being in a firefight is listen for orders. You know, if we, especially
contact
if we get more...
soldier.
You know, organized fire team leaders will probably be start to give out orders and things like that while you're in a fight. You know, one team may be suppressing and you might be in a team that's going to start moving. If you're not listening, you're not going to know that you're going to be moving and you're going to have no idea where your team went. You get stranded somewhere with a, you know, a shit ton of bullets flying at you. So try to listen. Yeah, I know, Karen. It's probably not going to happen.
Probably.
I disagree, you know, we were pretty organized yesterday, so,
yeah, that's true.
You know, yeah, it can happen, you know, I think we just need more games, that's all it is.
And I think as we start to play with each other more, we'll really get the hang of, you know, what the hell's supposed to be going on,
yeah,
and I think this
sure.
might,
I know,
I hope
yeah,
this...
yesterday's pretty cool, yeah.
Yeah, and I hope this helps, because, you know, if we all know what's going, if we're all on the same page, then it might give
both
us a bit more.
Sleep and that other one, we were doing the,
Look, we got another hero coming in from the west.
It's curly again.
I know Link Blue kept the... Someone shoot him down, please.
No.
Yeah, no, just don't even fire. Just fire.
Yeah, contact north, let's go.
That's not even...
That's south.
Southwest.
I know, but I want you to fire
south
the
south or southwest,
way.
Yeah. Alright, but yeah. Yeah, other than that, the last thing I have to say, you know, actions on casualty. You know, when somebody is down, basically, what you should know is, you know, if someone goes down and you're still in the middle of a firefight, okay, shoot him down. I'm tired of listening to that.
Yeah, please shoot him
he's
down.
Out.
He's out.
Okay, he's out. Yeah.
Okay,
never
mind.
Still
he's
still
out.
On.
He's out. Leave him alone.
The
engine. Go over there. Yeah, never. Never fucking turned off the engine.
Okay, alright, that's good enough.
That works, thank you.
Yeah,
good
all
enough. Alright.
User scroll wheel.
Alright. Yeah. Last fucking thing.
Actions on casualties.
actions on casualty. When someone goes down, if you're still in the middle of a firefight, don't have your medic come up there, especially with the revive script we've got now. That's a really bad idea. If there's still people shooting, don't send your medic up there. You're going to really fuck something up then.
Yeah.
So just make sure you finish the fight before you start reviving people. And again, while your medic is reviving, just have people surround him looking outwards. Make sure that you, you know, you've got a decent distance between you and then that way, you know, you're not standing around waiting for a grenade to destroy all of you.
Or at least but block bullets for him.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. It's... And that is pretty much it.
Oh, like, I have a question.
Yeah, go on.
Why do you guys call them kebabs?
Because we're most kebabs.
That's what they are.
Because
move kebab.
Yeah.
What?
It's someone... racial thing.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I assumed it was something like that.
That's
but
like,
I wasn't sure.
Like,
well, I mean, Americans are hamburgers.
Watermelons.
Okay. Yeah.
Well,
I don't know. It's not that offensive.
Grisha Laban
more
offensive.
Hey, does anybody, can anybody play that Serbia Strong song?
I don't have. Oh, I need it.
But yeah.
Well, how come
that,
you don't have
that's
ATG's
it for everything. I'm
song.
Done talking.
Are we gonna operate now?
I have a little thing.
Yeah,
down.
We can operate.
Upper bay.
I don't give a shit.
Upper bay.
Might as well, we're all here.
Drop and roll.
Grid 0, 2, 0, 0, 5,
really?
6.
Standing by.
Contact! Rifleman! One click, 6 o'clock.
How do we get here?
We died.
You all died.
Alright, hold on.
I think we turn that music off for just a second. I think Sonic had something to say. Thank you.
I have something to say.
Okay, yeah.
It was more along the lines of the radios. When we were talking about the radios, I think that people should use like basic shit, you know, like if you're Alpha 1-1 or whatever, you say like, you know, like if you're requesting something, you say, you know, Alpha 1-1 to Alpha 1-2 over.
Okay,
you know,
yeah, just like how to
learn
actually
over
speak over the
stuff.
Radio. Okay,
yeah,
I can go
just
over
a
that.
Little bit. I mean, we don't have to go into like super.
Yeah, I mean,
you
I don't
know,
think most people will bother with most
more
of
complex.
It. But yeah, if we can, yeah, as we get more people in here, I agree. But we're gonna have some issues with, you know, knowing who the hell is talking to you.
Yeah,
I would love radio structure.
We usually have
radio
like,
structure would
G5,
be nice. I mean, I could do an entire course on radio telephone operating. But
God, please.
Yeah, we also have to take out the ASVAB where we're at.
Like, last time we played that Annex mission, that
make sure
was
you qualify.
Pretty much perfect. We just had Alpha to Bravo, Bravo to Charlie, Alpha
yeah.
to Command, Command to Air, all that. That's how it works. That works
it's
fine.
It's a great stepping stone.
Yeah,
we
okay, yeah, I mean, basically...
Like, Etchy never shuts up.
Yes,
I was trying Etchy. To get in contact with Meh.
No, I mean, right, like, yeah. you'll be saying some shit for a long time.
Yeah,
and
sorry,
you'll be saying
I
it on the wrong radio. And I'll be yelling
yeah.
at you to
okay.
shut up so you can talk
yeah.
on the right radio.
Yeah, so you can't
actually,
hear when you're talking
hear you
on the radio.
The whole time, so.
Cause
yeah,
you're talking, yeah, exactly.
You can't hear someone when you're talking. Okay, basically, let's just go over this. Basic radio operating. Here's what you do. Okay, first thing you want to do when you talk over the radio, if, you know, you've got a lot of people there, whatever, you've got multiple squads, you want to say, hey you, this is me. So, you're Alpha, this is, or you're trying to talk to Bravo. Say, Bravo, this is Alpha. And then your message, whatever you know.
Or you can say Alpha Bravo.
Yeah, or you can just say Alpha Bravo.
Helicopter contact.
As long as you know. As long as you know who you're talking to and who's talking.
Grid 0, 2, 0, 0, 5, 6.
Ready.
So, as you were saying?
As I was saying. As long as you need to say just who you're talking to, and then who you are. So just remember that. If you have a really long thing you're saying over the radio, you know, you can't hear. Maybe there's someone else trying to get to you, maybe there's someone else trying to talk over the radio, and they got something more important than you. If you've got something really long to say, just say, wait. Oh, shit, not wait.
Oh, you mean break.
Break. Thank you. God damn it. I have it all written down. I've got everything, but yeah, thank you. Break. And then when you come back in, just make sure that you do the Alpha Bravo thing again. Just, hey you, this is me. That way they know who was talking again.
I fire up an example.
Alright, Sonics, you're Bravo, I'm Alpha.
Alright.
Bravo, this is Alpha. Or just want to do it over the radio, I don't care. Whatever.
I don't care.
Just do it over the radio.
Yeah, radio works. We're all on channel 1, right?
My emergence.
I think
we
so,
all
yeah.
died. We all died.
Yeah, at least that's what we died.
Yeah, it should be all reset.
Wait, is that you?
I have it's no idea who it is, and I don't all give right, a shit. Right. I well, literally do not care.
That all was right. awesome.
Okay, let's do this.
So,
control us.
Example.
Bravo, this is Alpha. Shit's happening, and other things. Whatever. Out. Or, over.
I don't know why you keep fucking it up.
Charlie copies.
Charlie, this is Alpha. I was talking to Bravo. Fuck off. Out. Goddamn, why do I keep saying
fuck off?
I'm useless.
Like it matters. Although, what we usually do is, we usually, like, if we're far away, for instance, if one squad is on this hill and one squad is over there, 600 meters, what you do is you're just like, Alpha, come in, over.
Alpha.
Alright, Alpha, this is Bravo. We have some shit going down here at the beach, over.
Copy, Bravo. Shit going down.
That's pretty much just how it works.
I mean, yeah, that's good enough. Nice. We don't really have to get too in the
or you can do it.
Too in depth.
Yeah. We can do it the more complex way.
No, we can't.
Or we don't.
Why do it simply?
No, I want to hear it though. I want to hear it though. Yeah, I like the complex.
No, it's fucking gay. I hate it.
Please, I really don't.
And I hate you. I don't actually hate you. I just don't care. What were you gonna say though?
Who, me?
Alpha 1-4, yeah. This is Alpha 1-2, come in, Alpha.
Oh, well, you know, like a basic contact report, you can be like,
yeah, I mean, I would love to do...
No, go on.
I love you.
Alpha 1, contact, grid, 0986-1456.
No.
One times enemy squad on position.
God, no.
Oh god, I wish.
Hell no. Never.
Good luck.
Where when targets are stationary and firing on our position.
I love you, Grave. I love you.
I love all of you.
Grave doesn't command, please shut up.
Requesting immediate air support at Widmark 020056, repeat 020056.
Boom.
I survived, you faggots. Oh yeah.
Grid 020056.
Ready for orders.
Good
ready
morning.
For orders.
Yeah, what I wanted to say still is communication.
Yeah.
Because when we're playing TBT, or sometimes when we're playing Outer Missions, I won't have a single clue what the fuck is going on, because we'll have squads at one side and squads on the other side, and they won't be communicating. And one squad will be either in contact, or they'll get wiped out, and nobody else will know because they weren't talking. They were just sitting there, being quiet, shooting at kebabs or getting shot by kebabs, and that's terrible.